What's going on, everyone? TallenV back here, and today it is time for a big news round update kind of thing. I know usually I would do a news thing during on Sundays and stuff like that, but year three definitely just threw me through a loop, and I know that was way off schedule and everything, but this stuff is pretty important information because I want to be covering two major things. One is the little information that you see in front of you about a totally new game, actually, that at least to what we the little information that we know about it. And then second is going to be just a bunch of updated news since the year three anniversary stuff has officially ended over on Dokkan. So let's get started. So first off is this new app that you are currently seeing on the screen right now. It says Dragonball, new smartphone app announcement coming in 13 days, 23 hours, 33 minutes, and 19, 18, 17, you get the idea, seconds. So now one thing to note about this is that if you actually scroll down on the page, and I'll have a link down in the description below so you can check it out, is there's going to be a live stream on from VJump, essentially, because it says right here VJump, and basically using one of the most popular live streaming apps over here in Japan, which is called this Live Nico Video. Essentially, you have to like make an account and everything with it. We will be able to stream this. Now, it is now one thing to note is that it's on the Wednesday, which is the 21st at 8 p.m. So but this is a holiday, actually. We actually have this day off here in Japan. I know, a random Wednesday off. So I thought to myself, you know what I'm going to do? And if you guys want me to, I'll put a poll up in the top right there. Do you want me to live stream this where I translate it when they, you know, show this off? Because apparently we're supposed to be getting gameplay and everything like that. If you, you know, you look at the kanji and everything, it says that there'll be gameplay reveal and everything. And from what I understand, or from what a lot of people have been saying, I'm not really sure why. In fact, Nano himself said this in his video, is that supposedly there is supposed to be a almost simultaneously, or maybe like a, maybe a month or maybe a couple weeks in between or something like that, there will also, there's gonna be a global and a JP release of this game, which, okay, cool, I'm all for it. You know, we're not gonna have some 6 month thing like Dokkan or anything like that, or maybe at the very most we'll have like kind of like a Blazing thing. I think Blazing for global is only a month behind or so when it comes to the JP version of the game. Again, I'm not sure on that because I don't really play the game. But that's actually really cool, and I don't know about you guys, but this looks pretty cool. I mean, that whole like Bushigiri thing, which is like a website game, that's mainly meant for Japan only, and it's gonna flop in my opinion, because you literally have to have a web browser open, and then like the whole multiplayer thing is not actually over the internet. It's supposed to somehow like use your phone or something like that. You know, you have to have your phone next to each other, essentially. So it's really weird. I don't see that game working out. This is supposed to be an actual smartphone app. When, you know, in 13 days we're supposed to see gameplay from what I can see, and there's, you know, an announcement trailer basically, right? They're gonna talk about it. They're gonna have the guys in the goofy hats and everything, and they're gonna be like, you know, yokoso yokoso, you know, welcome welcome, and then they're gonna do their little stream thing. I don't know how long the stream will be, but I'll definitely be over on Twitch probably streaming it. And if you guys want to stop on by, it now it is at a weird time, unfortunately. You know, 8 p.m. Japan time is around 3 a.m. maybe 4 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I will upload that to YouTube after I stream that, because that is just, that's definitely going to be kind of this like, whoa, kind of a really random time for especially a lot of people in the States. Maybe if you're over in Europe and everything, you'll see it, no problem. But at least in Japan or in America and the other States and everything, it's going to be like, okay, well, I'm not going to be able to catch this. I'll just catch the stream or anything like that. So let me know again if you guys want me to do that kind of live stream. And also let me know, because if this game, let's say it's 2 weeks, you know, in between, or, you know, something like that, then it's almost like, is there a point to playing the JP version? Because I know there are a lot of people who do not watch my channel or play Dokkan JP simply because they cannot read the Japanese, regardless of all of the resources out there to help you with it or anything like that. So let me know what you want me to play. I'm thinking I'm probably going to do both versions of the game, maybe where I focus on the JP version, but I also play the global version or something. Because the one thing that did cross my mind is, you know, even if they are exactly the same game, right? And let's say they're only 2 weeks in, you know, apart from each other, and there's, you know, absolutely no point to trying to translate everything because you're just going to see it in 2 weeks or something like that. JP does have one thing that global will never have, no matter what kind of DBZ game you're playing, and that is called Dragon Ball Heroes. And I don't know, again, what kind of game this is. I don't know how the gameplay is or anything like that. But I guarantee you there will be some Dragon Ball Hero stuff. So that's at least some stuff to translate there. So I think I'll probably do both versions of the game. If it is something that's cool and it really takes off and everything like that, again, it could potentially flop. And, you know, after a week of trying it out, everyone's going to be like, okay, well, I guess wait for the next one, right? So again, let me know both of those. I'll have two polls in the top right corner. So just go ahead and check those out real quick. This, I'm going to say this right now, this will not kill Dokkan. Dokkan makes way too much money. They just hit the App Store first place for like the third time in less than a month. Dokkan's going nowhere. This will run alongside Dokkan. Dokkan makes way too much money for Bandai. They're not going to get rid of it. So anyone who's thinking that this is going to kill Dokkan or replace it or anything like that, that's not going to be the case. So just keep that in mind when you're looking at this, and we'll have to see what it's like. I'm definitely interested. 13 more days, and yeah, we'll have to see what it's like. So again, let me know in those polls up in the top right corner, as usual. Now, let's go ahead and move over to a bunch of the Dokkan information. A lot of it is pretty just fast information real quick. These next few ones that I'm going through, this is basically just saying that you have until this day to use these certain items and everything, and otherwise if you wait, they're going to be gone, okay? So the first one is saying that the Purple Dragonstone, because right now you can still go into the Baba shop right now, and you will see all the 120% leaders if you bought the Purple Stone and you have not used it yet. There's no extra Purple Stone or anything like that. This is simply the first one that we originally got way back in February. At the beginning of it, at least. If you have not spent the Purple Dragon Stone, then you have until the 12th Japan time that's 3 p.m. actually, yeah, so... Sanjima Day. So basically you need to go ahead and pick whatever leader you want to take. If you wait too long, then the stone will disappear. Or actually, you'll probably keep the stone, but the characters are going to disappear from the Baba Shop. You're not going to be able to do it. So make sure you do that. And same thing with the Red Dragon Stone that you got. Go ahead and pick whatever character you want. I have a feeling probably 99% of people have already picked what they want to. But again, just keep in mind real quick that you do need to take that out real quick. Same with the year 3 anniversary coins here. Use those right now. Do not wait. Do not think you can save them for next year or anything like that, because there's going to be year 4 anniversary coins and everything. So again, just go ahead and do that real quick. Go in, buy whatever you need to, and it should be good. And then last real quick, again, we hit the App Store first place for the third time in a row. You should have seen these in your box already. We got 3 of each Kai, or Grand Kai, essentially. And then we got a bunch of orbs, basically. Oh, and then we also got 777 Incredible Gems. So it's basically actually taking the very first 3 wishes of the Purunga missions. We essentially just got that again right here with these rewards. That's pretty cool. Basically got 4 wishes, or 4 sets of wishes, I guess. So, and then for anyone who will ask me about this, because it says Puzzle, this is only really for Android when it comes. So this has to do with that whole Gacha thing or whatever that has to do with basically stopping rerolling. Essentially, they implemented this right before the year 3 anniversary started. iPhone users, you don't really have to we don't have to deal with this, so we're fine. But if you've ever tried to like restart the game or delete the app, open it up again, start a new account, all that kind of stuff on like Android and other devices, usually you got to take like this little puzzle piece and you put it in. It's like a Kasha or whatever it's called. I don't really know the names, but they're kind of a pain in my opinion. But basically this, it was like not working or something like that for like the last week or two or something, and now it's like being implemented again, essentially what's this is saying. So just keep that in mind if you're on the Android devices or other devices that run the game. iOS users, you're totally fine. You don't have to worry about it. So that's just something to keep in mind right there. The last little bit of information that I want to quickly go over is the fact that the survival tournament story event is back. So if you have not farmed up this Goku here, this little physical Goku who then Dokkan awakens into the UI Goku here, this guy can be used to up the SA of the Int one if you did not. I'm going to say this right now, guys, because I know a lot of people will still ask me this question. You cannot take one Goku, get him up to SA10 and farm them into the Int one. You have to get 9 separate SA1 physical UI Gokus up to UR status. Do not make it SSR status, make it UR status, and then you can feed them into the Int one if he comes back on the 18th, which we're all anticipating because of the episode and everything, okay? If you keep him at SSR status and you have the UI Goku and you now can finally raise that super attack or anything like that, you only get a 50% chance when he's in SSR, when he's like this right here, okay? Get him up to the UR status. It's a 100% increase in the SA right there, which means you throw in 5 of them first, that gets him up to SA6, throw in 4 more, you get him up to SA10, okay? Remember, 9 of these physical Gokus right here, 9, okay? 9 physical Gokus into one, and you get them up to SA10, okay? Now, what I don't know is that so I did a prediction video saying that on the 18th, after the next Dragon Ball Super episode airs, we are gonna get some kind of, you know, mastered UI form, the picture that's been going around the internet that a lot of people should know about already. We'll probably get the Intuan back, or the Intuan is finally getting his Dokkan Awakened. We don't really know that details and information. I went over that stuff about my personal thoughts and opinions on it, about what we could potentially get. I do not know, though, if this physical one will be available to use on, say, a new mastered card or something like that. But bottom line, I would say if you don't have UI Goku, get 90 of these guys up to SA1, up to a UR, and also get him up to SA10, just have him for yourself. He's not a bad free-to-play unit. He honestly isn't. Also, the Golden Frieza, make sure you guys get those. Again, 9 of these guys to throw into the Int Angel Golden Frieza will get him up to SA10 at the UR status, so make sure you do that as well. Definitely on the Frieza, definitely on the Goku as well. If you already have UI Goku to SA10, I don't really think you'd really need to farm up 9 more in case there is some new UI Goku. I could be completely wrong, though, because again, we don't know what's coming out just yet. But one thing to note is that the episode airs on the 18th, and if they release that, whatever potential banner comes with that kind of hype, because let's face it, you know they're going to. That banner will probably come out on that Sunday, which is the 18th, which also happens to be Sand Day, actually. If you remember from last year, that's when we got the Mass Sand and the SSJ3 Angel Goku, the tech leader. So we could potentially get something like that. Global, I believe you guys are getting the EZA and stuff like that for the SSJ3 Goku. I'm not 100% sure if you will get other things, but it's hard to say. JP, I'm assuming we're probably gonna get, though, that banner, that'll probably be the next Dokkan Fest banner, because right now we're obviously in a break, we don't have a Dokkan Fest banner. We'll probably get it on the 18th or around that time or so because of the episode hype and everything like that. But note that this event goes away on the 20th, which is Tuesday, which is 2 days after. So if they potentially wait on that hype banner from the episode and wait till, say, Thursday, and this goes away on the 20th, and UI Goku comes back, the Int one, and whether there is a new mastered form or anything like that, then you will miss your chance to get him up to SA10. So again, if you don't have him and you want to try pulling for him, or maybe you'll eventually get him in the future, farm up 9 of those guys and just hold on to them. A lot of people have done that with like the SSJ3 Goku and the Brawly and all that kind of stuff in the past. So again, it's worth it, I think, to do it for this, and it saves you having to use your Kais. If you want to use your Kais, by all means, go ahead. I would do, you know, a lot of people have Grand Kais they probably just want to get rid of. Then by all means, just go ahead and wait and save up your Int ones for that. I'm saving up the Agility ones because I am hoping there is a new card in there, whether it's a Mastered Form Vegeta or whatever it happens to be, and maybe he will be Agility because Agility needs a new card. So. And then obviously next week we should be getting the Battlefield 2.0. I don't know the exact date. We're saying the 15th, give or take, maybe the 16th, hard to say, but I personally can't wait. So yeah. So anyway, guys, that's going to be it for all the news and information and translations and everything. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments as always. Leave a like if you liked the video. Subscribe if you happen to be new. And until next time, everyone, I will see you all in the next one.